Pick any problem you have with anybody. Anybody who's doing something you don't want them to do or not doing something you want them to do, anything, and you really only have three options. In our approach, we call these your three plans. We call it plan A when you try to impose your will to make the person do what you want them to do. And if you have power over that person and they have decent skills related to problem solving, flexibility, and frustration tolerance, you might get away with it and it would go okay. What are your other options? To try to collaborate to solve a problem in mutually satisfactory ways. And your third option, to drop it. Solve it the way the other person wants. Drop your expectation, not forever, but for now. And parents, teachers, all of us, often find ourselves resorting to plan A to try to impose our will. And if it doesn't work out well, it gets ugly on us, we revert to plan C. But there's a third option. And the third option is what we call plan B. And here's simple but not easy. Plan B has three basic ingredients to it. Ingredient number one is where we teach people to listen hard to the other person, to ask questions, to take guesses, to reflect what they've heard from the person, and to reassure them that this is not some tricky form of plan A, which we often do. We often do what I call empathy followed by plan A. No, first you're getting the other person's concern or perspective on the table, and it's only once you do that you move to the second ingredient of plan B, where you share your concern, not your solution to the problem, but your concern. And only once you have two sets of concerns on the table do you move to the third and final ingredient of plan B, where you invite the person to collaborate to arrive at mutually satisfactory solutions to the problem.